Scouting my house again, I see. Forgive me for scaring you. Hello, little intruder. Care to come in? You must be wondering why the object of your constant spying is allowing you into their home. However, word travels quickly, and now I know why you're oh, so interested in me. It's the marionettes, right? You wonder how the great puppet master Amelie has managed to get their hands on such realistic and high-quality puppets. Well, aren't you in luck? There. I've left the door unlocked and given you an opportunity to enter. Surely more secrets can be uncovered within my humble abode. Unless you wish to continue studying from afar. A wise decision, love, and definitely the correct one. Now, have a seat. I have a few minutes to spare before my last puppet show in this town. I promise to dedicate each and every one to you, and every endearing little doubt that enters that curious mind of yours. So, doll, how may I aid you in your quest to, as you said, and may I quote, unveil my tricks. Silence. Quite unexpected, coming from the person who's been observing my home day and night in your so-called search for the truth. How sad. I expected more fight and spite from you. If I may be perfectly honest, is this the same person that came to every single one of my shows in an almost religious manner? Amusing and yet so adorable. Seeing you as you keep your head down, that delicious blush spreading over your cheeks. Delightful. An idea has crossed my mind. In an effort to aid you and not waste my time any further, how about I ask the questions? Perhaps if I lead this show, things will start moving a little more smoothly. What do you think? The slightest of nods. Meek little thing, aren't you? Perfect. Now, first question. What are puppets to you, doll? Are they toys, means of entertainment? Or are you the type that likes to see things as they are? A wooden figurine tied with strings. Well, whatever your answer may be, it surely won't match mine. You see, to me, marionettes are family, trophies, and in some ways, prized possessions all at once. Surely, you must wonder, what is so great about simple dolls controlled by strings? Predictable. I'll answer that silly question with another one. Do you know why the strings on my dolls here are so important? Aha! Bravo, sweetie. Yes, It's because otherwise the puppet wouldn't be able to move. But there's something else too. Those strings connect me to my little toy. Thanks to me, they can move. They can walk. They can dance. They can do anything. With those strings, I can control their every single movement. Imagine for a moment that you were my doll. Paint this little image in your mind. What would life be like if you were a wooden puppet? You wake up one day and can't move one bit. You try to gather your strength to stand up and can't. The familiar rise and fall of your chest as you breathe, gone. And even if you part your lips to let out a scream, nothing. Not a sound. Unable to do anything but stare blankly into space, waiting, hoping for something, someone to help you. That, sweetness, is where I come in. I'd free you of your motionless state, bringing back some life to your limbs. You could walk, run, dance as always. Not for free, of course. All this at the small price of keeping my silk chains on your hands and feet. Would you take the deal, doll? Would you be mine to get your life back? No? How dare I suggest such a thing? Oh, that's the spite I was missing. That delicious spark that all my puppets lack. It puts me on edge, getting on my nerves, and yet it's the very thing that draws me in. However, I'm surprised you would choose the equivalent of death over me. Is your pride really that great? Not everyone thinks like you, doll. Especially not any of the ones in my collection. What do I mean by that? Well, surely you didn't think such lifelike puppets as mine were wooden, did you? Not so fast, sweetie. A little prick in the neck, and there. Quite quick, aren't you? With your speed, you could have gotten away from anyone. But me, I've been at this for years now, doll. Nevertheless, it is not I who is to blame for all of this. It's you. And every single one of the marionettes in my collection. You could have kept your normal lives, not separated from your loved ones, in the state of naive happiness, if only you hadn't come to my show. You see, love, the day I laid my eyes on you, something sparked my interest. My desire to take you with me, to keep you. And so I would try to draw your attention, weaving my web with the hopes that you would fall. And you fell. You all did. Every single time. Is that fear in your eyes I see, darling? Why, though? I take good care of my puppets. You can ask the rest of them. Oh, don't be jealous, dear. I love you all the same, and I'll make sure to give you some extra special attention at first, so you can get used to being part of the family and to being mine. One last thing, darling. As I said before, you do have a choice to give up control and be my doll or not. As promising as a second option might seem, I wouldn't recommend it. You see, the agent I injected you with has rendered you motionless for quite some time. If you decide to go against coming with me, I'll leave you abandoned in the woods nearby after my show and leave town. Oh, how it would break my heart to leave you in the open in that state. But I can't have you ratting me out now, can I? The thought of you being easy prey for some wild animal sends chills down my spine. And in the miraculous case that someone did find you and managed to bring you back to town, you'll most likely be declared a lost cause and be put down to end your suffering. That gaze, once fearful, is now perfectly blank. I take it you've come to a decision. So, doll, I will ask you for the last time. Would you like to become my new puppet?